Hello everyone, in this video we will be discussing very important and the last topic in the module 1, that is nothing but the stress concentration. So when we had discussion on theories of failure, we discussed indirectly about the stress concentrations. Now in this video we will discuss in detail about stress concentration, its concept. We know that the basic stress equations for tension, compression, bending and torsion are based on number of assumptions. One of the assumptions is that if there is no geometrical irregularities or if there is any abrupt change in the cross-section of the member, but these irregularities and changes in the cross-section of the members are unavoidable because this is a practical cases. So and even there can be holes, oil grooves, notches, keyways, splines, screw threads, etc. So any of these discontinuities in the machine part alters the distribution of stress in its vicinity, and localized stress much higher than those calculated with the elementary stress equations are observed. This localization of the high stresses due to geometrical irregularities or abrupt changes of the cross section is called stress concentration, and these discontinuities are called the stress risers. Here you can able to see that this particular component where there is a change of cross section from here to here, that is from this end to this end, and even you can able to see from this end to this end, the whole part, let me consider as a part 1 and part 2. So the cross section is same, but suddenly from here there is a change of cross section. So say for example a tensile load is applied on this particular component, the load distribution in red color you can able to see that the place where the cross section is more, there is no problem, but when there is change of cross section, the load is distributed like this according to the shape of it. So what happens, this is this particular point the stress starts accumulate. So usually we know that for the tensile stress it is P by A, and for the bending stress MB into Y by I, and for the shear it is MT into R divided by G. Similarly for the other cases, let me take a fillet. So again the change of cross section, and where there is a change cross section is taking, there only the stresses will be accumulating or concentrating. So the localization of the high stresses due to the irregularities present in the component and the abrupt changes of the cross section. So to consider the effect of the stress concentration factor is used. So which is ratio of maximum stress to the nominal stress. The stress concentration factor for the normal stress and the stress concentration factor for the shear stress is written as KT is equal to sigma max by sigma naught, and KT is equal to tau max divided by tau naught. This is for the brittle and ductile material. This is for the similarly for the brittle and ductile material, and this is for the stress condition, this is for the shear condition. The value of the stress concentration factor depends on the geometry of the part only if it is independent of the material used. For this reason only it is called the theoretical or the geometrical stress concentration factor. The stress concentration factor for the different geometric shapes are found by using experimental techniques like photoelasticity, grid methods, brittle coating methods and electrical strain gauge methods. And here we can able to see the causes of the stress concentration where there is any variation in the property. Example, you can able to see this particular sketch. This is a different component, this is a different component. These two has been joined with the help of a third material, a second material by means of your welding. So what happens, and because of the change of material, so obviously some impurities and kinds will be there. So voids or cavity we could able to see. So when a tensile load is applied on this one, means because of the change in cross section, change of material, so obviously the stress will concentrate because of the irregular load distribution. And the load distribution, even you can able to see, for example, let me consider this bearing and even any kind of gears also you can able to see this. The places where there is any change of cross section only, the stress will be induced. And even there are some examples where, look at this particular machine, where this particular part only I am talking about. If any load is applying on this particular part, what happens? The load distribution will be equal, but the places only where the holes is present, obviously there is no material here, so the stress will concentrate on this particular part only. Similarly, look at this example where a keyway is present here. So if you any load is applied on this one, means all these portions is having a uniform cross section, but only at this region there is a keyway present. So obviously, because of change in cross section and non availability of the material, the stress will accumulate on this particular point. And even some other possibilities like the scratches on the machining marks on the component also leads to water stress concentration. And here how to find out the stress concentration value theoretically. If it is a plate with hole, or if it is a these kind of a fillet component, means by using this graph only, directly theoretical values can be able to find out. Where we will be finding out the x-axis value, that is d by w. D is nothing but the diameter of the hole, and w is nothing but the width of the plate. For the plate with hole example I am telling about, first we will be finding out the x-axis d by w value. Whatever the value we will be getting, that we'll be finding out where exactly it is correspondingly touching the line. That will be equal to our KT, that is the stress concentration. And similarly, let me take this particular example where a normal plate with the change of cross section, and the cross section is circle. So if this is the case, means first I will be finding out x axis r by d. So we know what is capital D, what is small d. So from this I will be finding out the r by d. That is, r is nothing but the radius of the fillet, and small d is nothing but the smaller dimensions. Why we need to go to the smaller dimension, means because the failure is happening only on the smaller portion where the cross section is reduced. After finding out r by d, I will be finding out d by d, where d is nothing but this the bigger cross section area divided by d. So by comparing this these r by d and db, where exactly it is coinciding, that particular point with respect to the y axis, will be finding out the kt. And what are the methods to reduce the stress concentration? Here can you be able to see this. For example, if this is the component present where there is a change of cross section, means by means of creating the additional notches on the holes in the tension members. So by creating additional notches, you can able to see this. If this is the places, means near to this some other smaller notches should be created. And like if there is any holes are present, means here we can go with the multiple holes here and there, so that we can able to see the use of multiple notches drilling additional holes and removal of the undesired materials. So with this video gets completed. Thank you.